Here we have a test setup that shows the performance of our air-to-air heat exchangers. These are our pipe-to-pipe products. This happens to be a vertical configuration where we have a simulated supply airstream on the bottom and a simulated exhaust airstream on the top. The supply air is being flowed from left to right in this image, and the exhaust is coming from the opposite direction, so we have a cross-flow situation. This is an active demo right now, so we are actively heating the air coming in from the supply side. So we're simulating a summer environment. If you can read this, this says 94 degrees Fahrenheit. That's the air temperature entering our air-to-air heat exchanger. For the exhaust side, we have just the room air. It happens to be about 74 degrees Fahrenheit in our room right now. So we're exhausting 74 degrees Fahrenheit air across the other side of the coil. So what we're seeing is that the supply air is being cooled down by the exhaust air through our heat pipe heat exchanger here from 94 degrees Fahrenheit down to 81. The maximum amount of temperature difference we had available was 94 to 74, so 20 degree available temperature difference, and we're cooling down about 12 degrees, so we're getting about a 60% effectiveness for this coil right here. And then you can see we're heating up the exhaust air, as you'd expect, from 74 up to 89 degrees, so you can see how the temperatures across the system work. This is a totally passive system, so this is a heat pipe heat exchanger operating in a vertical configuration. This is typical for applications. It could be a direct replacement for an energy wheel that would normally be in this application, but this does the same thing without any moving parts.
Wraparound heat exchanger heat pipe products. These products are used for enhanced dehumidification for large air conditioning systems. In traditional air conditioning systems, you take the outside air, which is presumably hot and humid air, it comes into your system and you cool it down through a cooling coil. It's either a DX coil or a direct expansion for a vapor compression system or a chilled water coil. That coil cools down the air, condenses the water vapor that's in the air down, so now you have 100% humid cold air that you don't want to send to your space because that would be uncomfortable. And so you often need to heat it right back up again to get the humidity level right and the temperature right for human comfort. So that means you have to do a lot of energy to cool down and condense the water vapor out of the air, and then you have to do a lot more energy to heat it back up. What our products do is passively take that energy from before the cooling coil, help pre-cool that air, maybe condense a little bit of water vapor out, the energy move it around the condensing coil to reheat the system. You can see a demo active right now. We have 96 degree air with a relative humidity of 14% coming into our heat exchanger. We're cooling that air down with our pre-cool coil down to 77 degrees. That means less tonnage required on the air conditioning system. The cooling coil is doing its job, condensing the water vapor out, getting the air down to about 53 degrees. And then all that energy we took out of the front coil is getting transferred passively to the downstream. We're heating the air up to a comfortable 70 degrees for the occupants in the room. These systems are totally passive. They require no moving parts. And we have options where you can control the amount of reheat you're doing, more or less, for all types of applications. For more information, you can visit our website to find out about these products.